Today I want to demonstrate how to create a modal control in WPF, and that's going to allow us to support common use cases and applications such as showing dialogue messages or just popping up crucial information for an application. So the demo is going to work something like this. I have this example window here if we run this application, and all I have is a button here to show the modal, and when I click this we should get a pop-up and some kind of content inside that pop-up that we can do whatever we want based on what we want our application to do. So let's begin this with the same way that we begin all of our UI workshops, and we're going to create a new project over here, and it's going to be a WPF custom control library, and I will call this the modal control. And let's do the usual cleanup, so we're going to rename this to modal. That's our custom control, and it should also rename the class while we're here. And then in the generic.xaml, we need to update custom control 1 to be our modal class that we just renamed, and update the control template as well. And we'll come back here later to implement this control template for our custom modal control that we're going to implement here. That's going to be the code for the modal. And let's get rid of this gigantic comment. We know what we're doing here. We don't need no help. So I think the first thing I want to consider is what kind of dependency properties am I going to need? Well, a modal can be open or it can be closed. So let's have a dependency property for isOpen. So this will be a prop DP. My good old Visual Studio snippet should be built in the Visual Studio. The isOpen property, it'll be a boolean, so true or false. The owner class will be my modal, and by default we'll go with false, so it'll be closed by default. What else will a modal have? Well, we're gonna have to put something inside of the modal. It's gonna have content, so we could define a content dependency property, but instead of inheriting from control, I'm gonna inherit from content control. And if we look at content control, we now have this content dependency property where we can take in whatever content we want to show in our modal, and we'll use that content in our control template. And I think these are actually all of the dependency properties I'll need right now. Maybe we'll add a few more later when we want to customize this a little bit more. But now let's head into the generic.xaml and set up the default control template for our modal. So this is what is actually going to be shown in the UI, so this is pretty important. So I'm thinking I can actually leave this default border that got scaffolded out for us, and inside this border we're gonna have a content control, and the content is gonna be a template binding to our content dependency property. So whatever we put inside of the modal will be displayed within this border, and I think this is actually all I want to do for a simple modal. We're gonna customize this a lot more, but let's go into the demo window and set this up. So right above my stack panel, I am going to have my modal. And before we can use this, we have to add a project reference to our modal control project. There we go, all good. And now I can control dot this and add the namespace for the modal control. I'm going to rename this and just call it custom. And we need some content in here, so let's do that. So whatever we put inside of this modal control right here is going to be set as the content property on the modal. And that content property, of course, we inherit from content control. And then we also use that content to display on our control template. So we're going to display whatever we put inside here. So what do we want? Let's just have another stack panel. Actually, I'm just going to copy this and put it inside of the modal. Except instead of show modal, it's going to be btn close modal. Its content will be close modal. And let's set up a different click handler here. This will be on close modal click. And let's actually implement these click handlers in our window code behind. So if we come back here, first we're going to need another one for on close modal click. But when we click the show modal button, what do we want to do? Well, we want to take our modal. So let's actually give it a name so that we can reference it. We'll just call it modal. And we want to set isOpen to true. So isOpen is what we used as our dependency property that denotes whether or not we should show the modal. And then whenever we click close, we will set isOpen to false. And now that I think about it, we're not even using this isOpen dependency property inside of our control template. So this is always going to be visible, and that's not what we want. So we want to toggle the visibility on this root border here. We want it to be collapsed if isOpen is false, and then visible if isOpen is true. And the easiest way to set that all up is by using a boolean to visibility converter. So we can define that in our control template resources, give it a key, This key is how we're going to reference it. We'll just call it the Boolean to visibility converter. And now for this visibility property that we set, we can template bind to our Boolean property of isOpen, and we can convert that using our Boolean to visibility converter. So if isOpen is true, this will be visible, and if it's false, it'll be collapsed. Anyways, I think I'm ready to test this out. There's still a few more things that we're gonna have to add to make it look good, but we should have our functionality there. All right, here we go. Let's show the modal, and where's the content? Well, we can't see the content, but it is there. The reason we can't see it is because we're covering the modal with this stack panel right here, but we want our modal to be on top. So we could set the Z index here. We'll do something like 10. And if we look at this, there we go. There's our close modal button. So we can click that and it's all gone. So changing the Z index and putting this modal on top definitely solved our problem with our content not being visible. But we still kind of have an issue here because even when we show the modal, it's kind of hard to visually recognize that we're inside of a modal. Maybe when I open this, I would want some kind of border around my content, and maybe I would want the background to be some kind of color, maybe dimmed a little bit. So those are some things that we can add to visually denote that we're inside of a modal, and those are some things that I do want to add. So what I want to do first is set a background on this modal. So let's set this to, I don't know, something like red, and now when I show the modal, okay, the background changes. So it's kind of clear that this is now the focus, this close modal button. But let's say I want this to be bigger. So let's have my content be 300 by 300. And now I kind of have an issue with this because maybe I don't want my inner content to be red. Maybe I want it to just be a regular white so that my content stands out from the background. So let's set this background to white. And okay, that's better. I'm kind of thinking this background is a little bit too hard for me. What if we could add some opacity? So it's kind of just dimming the background rather than setting this flat red. Well, let's try just setting the opacity on the modal. We'll do 50. And actually, opacity I think has to be a value between 0 and 1, not 0 and 100. So let's try 0.5. And okay, that dimmed the background, but it also dimmed our content. And that is not what we want. So what we have to actually do is set the background opacity to a value, and by setting the background opacity, it's not going to affect our actual content opacity. So to set a background with an opacity, we can take our modal and set the background inside of these tags, and by doing this, we get more customization over the solid color brush that's going to get set as our background. So we can set the color, and we want that to be red in this case. But we can also set the opacity, which we want as 0.5. And by doing it here, it's only going to affect the background, not the actual content that's inside of our modal. Okay, that's much better. I think that's what we want. I want to get this button back in the center too. So I think the easiest way to do that is to surround this with a grid, move the width and height onto that, and then leave everything else on this internal stack panel. And I also want the background on this grid as well. There we go, that's good. I think another thing we can do is kind of round these corners a little bit, make them a little bit less sharp. And the best way to do that is just by, I think we can actually change this grid into a border and then set the corner radius. We'll do something like 5, not too much. Okay, that looks nicer. And then just the edges in general are kind of sharp. So I think one thing I want to do is set a little drop shadow just to smooth out the little transition that we have here. And to do that, we can have our border have some effect. And the effect we want is a drop shadow effect. And we can do all kinds of stuff in here. We can set the blur radius. We'll try out 10. Shadow depth, maybe 10 as well. And see how that looks. It's a little bit too much. Let's go with a lighter color, maybe regular gray. And that really gives us an effect that this is above the content, because we kind of have this shadow here, so it's floating. That looks nice. All right, so the last thing I want to cover before we get back into the actual modal control and adding onto that is if we look at our modal, this is kind of a weird thing, but when we open this, it looks kind of blurry. And one way to solve that is by setting use layout rounding to true. And what that property does is some magic with the pixel boundaries, so we don't get that blurriness anymore. And there we go, that looks much better. So back to our actual modal control. I want to develop this a little bit more because if we look at the content inside of our modal, a lot of this should probably be reused across our entire modal, such as the drop shadow, maybe the border. We should also add a default background so that we don't have the issue before where there was just no background and we couldn't even tell we were in a modal. So let's go ahead and do that. The first thing I want to do is move the border effect into my modal control, because I think I want all modals to have that drop shadow. So we can just paste that in there. And do we think this is really going to do what we had before? It's actually not, because the root of our control template is this border, and our border takes up the entire screen. But we want this effect to be applied to this border inside here. And this border right here is actually set inside of our modal content. So I actually also want to move this border into my modal. So I'm just going to copy this, drop it inside of here, and then add another border closing tag down there. And now width and height, I'm actually going to remove, because I want my inner content to decide the width and height of the modal, and also the background. Let's have the content decide what kind of background color they want as well. And that's the background color for the internal content, not the background color of everything outside of the modal. And also the border thickness and border brush template bindings should probably go on the internal border, because if they go on the outside border, we're not even going to be able to see those changes because that border spans the entire width and height of the screen. And now that we've done all this, this surrounding tag doesn't even have to be a border. We can just make it a grid. That simplifies things. And let's remove the things we no longer need on this inner border, that is our actual content. So the corner radius is handled in our modal, same with the layout rounding, and the background's going to be left to us, so we can leave all that. And actually this can just be a grid as well. So as you can see, this content is already a lot simpler, and let's see how this looks in action. So it looks pretty good, same thing as before, except we no longer get our rounded corners. And why is that? Well, that is because this grid takes up our entire border that we have here. And since we have a background on this grid, this background actually covers the rounded corners, which is kind of ridiculous. That's not what we want. So I actually run into this corner radius issue a lot in WPF, and there is some magic we can do to solve this. So the easiest solution is to have a grid inside of this border. And we're going to set an opacity mask on this grid, and it'll be a visual brush, and the visual is going to be a binding to some kind of border that we're going to create. We're going to call it just border, and this border that we create is going to take care of the rounding for us, and it'll be inside of this grid. So a border that has to be named border, and the corner radius here will be 5, because that's what we ultimately want. So we actually remove it up here. And then we move the content control inside of the grid. And that's actually all we have to do. So let's see this in action. And okay, that's not quite what we want, because this border is being used as a mask. So it needs a background, and that will be white. All right, so we show the modal, and it doesn't look like what we had before, but we're really close, because if we look up here at all these corners, we can see the corner radius. We can see the red background. All we have to do now is horizontal align and vertical align our border in the center of our control so that it doesn't fill the entire space of our page. All right, and there we go, finally. So we have the customization we want. We can decide what we want this background color to be outside of the control. So we can change this to green or something like that. There we go. And we can change the inner content as well. So maybe we want gray. That's going to look pretty bad. But there we go. That is actually what we want. That looks good. But let's say I forget to set the background. And then we look at this. So no backgrounds are being set anywhere. And now we have this really weird drop shadow that just looks really weird, because we don't have any visual distinction between the modal and the background. So I want to dim this background by default. And what we're going to do is come into our modal, and we can take the background property. So that is the dependency property that we bind to in our control template that sets the background. And we're going to override the metadata. And the type of our control is the modal. And we're going to set new framework property metadata. And we can pass it a default value. So I'm actually going to create this default value in a function. So create default background and generate that method. And our default background is going to be a solid color brush. that, in my case, I want to be black, but I want that opacity that we've been using so that it just looks dimmed and it's not completely blacked out, and I want that to be 0.5. So now if we try this again, there we go, that looks pretty good. Maybe we could dim it a little bit more, maybe like a 0.3 or something. That's not going to change anything. We got to restart the app. There we go. I'm liking that. All right, so that is the modal control. Now, one thing I want to say before I wrap this up is that your modal should really go at the root of your application so that it'll span the entire width and height of the page. And another thing, let's say you have rows at the root of your application. So we have two rows here. Then this is going to look really messed up because it's only going to take up the first half of your window because we need this to span both rows. So we can set the row span to 2, and then it takes up the entire height of the application. And same thing with columns as well. So make sure that this modal spans the entire height and width of your window, unless you have some kind of other weird use case. Anyways, that is modals in WPF. I think I might actually publish this one as a NuGet package, so keep an eye out for that. I'll leave a link in the description if I do. If you have any questions, criticisms, or concerns, be sure to leave them below in the comments section. Other than that, leave a like or subscribe for more. Thank you.